So in this video, I want to show you how to create your own buttons. As you can see here, we have many types of buttons and elements in the design system. At the same time that we're creating our first button, we're also learning how to use the design system itself. So the first thing you want to do is go to create your own template or your own page. Or you can also design something next to here. Now, in my case, I want to show you where we store all the buttons, and that would be the page called buttons right here. And this is typically how you organize your buttons. And ideally, you only want to have as little number of variants as possible. In this case, we have multiple ones because we have multiple styles. But if, let's say, you have a very simple design, you can essentially just have a single style, a single button, and not even have variants. So that depends on the complexity of your design system. That depends on how many component properties that you have, such as here, we decided to have many so that you have more flexibility to adapt to the design that you want. So let's start to create our very first button. And here I'm setting the first text. So I'm going to press T and my button. And here you would want to, let's say you start without the textile. Okay. It's going to look pretty much like this one. And you want to use one of the textiles. And typically the first one that you want to use is called the body. Now you have the regular one and you have the medium one. The difference is simply how much emphasis that you want to put on your text. In this case, it's a button, so it has a little bit more emphasis on it. So I'm going to use medium. And so I'm using medium body. And then you also want to have an icon. Usually a button has an icon. And so in this case, we have a pretty huge library of icons, and you can browse that directly in the icons page. Each of these icons are unique, so you can search them quite easily by doing a search, command F, or you can also, I'm going to go back to the buttons here, and you can do Shift I to insert a component. And here we have different components from the design system. We have thousands of variants. So in this case, we have icons and it's organized by categories. And let's say you want to use, let's say these symbols like this one. And you can see that we have a lot of these icons that you can use for your button. And so a typical one would be the chevron, so you can search for it. I'm going to search for chevron right, and I'm just going to drag and drop that here. And so this is what it looks like. Now, the next part is to set your colors. And typically you want to use the variable colors, especially for text and icons, because it's quite easy to adapt to light mode and dark mode. And since it's not a gradient, you don't have to worry about not supported by variables. So in this case, I'm going to go to the colors. Instead of selecting from millions of colors, I'm going to select the style. And here at the very top, you can find the square colors. These are the variables. And if you scroll down a little bit more, you're going to find the styles by the circles. That's how you differentiate between styles and variables. Now, if you want to know more about variables, you can go watch my live stream about design system, and you can also go to each of these pages, including the colors, the spacing rules and the shadows. But specifically the colors and spacing are using variables prominently. So I definitely recommend that you read all of this stuff here and you look at the examples as to how they are used. So once you understand kind of like how these work, we're going to apply that to our button. So now I'm going to select one of the colors And typically you want, for text, you want to select foreground. Foreground means the foreground elements. So it can include text or icons or anything that is in front. So primary, and the reason why primary is because that's the main color, and also because it's using variables, it's going to adapt between light and dark mode. So once I have this, I'm going to do the same with the icon, but it is already set by default. And then I'm going to use auto layout to put them together. So I'm going to select the two of them and shift A. This is going to create a frame, and also it's going to create the auto layout. Here I can set the direction. So top to bottom or left to right. And I can also use wrap. Eventually, this is something that you want to use for layout. But in the case of a button, you don't really need that. So I'm just going to set left and right. Now, this is where we need to set the spacing of the button. Okay. And to help you a little bit, we're going to set the background first. So I'm going to go to fill. And again, we also have the variable colors. So you have the foreground and then you have the background, but you also have the container. So in this case, it's not the background, because the background is typically for your entire canvas. So for example, the background of the entire screen, but the container is more like a background of a card or the background of a button. And you can also use the button background, but this is more if you want your button to have a primary color, an active color, a hover color. But in most cases, especially for a secondary button or a container or a card, you would want to use the container background. So I'm going to do that. The container background automatically adapts to the variable color for the foreground, which means that black text against white background with some translucency. So this is what we have so far. And now that I have my button, I can start setting the spacing. For a lot of designers, this is all very confusing, like which number to use, what is the correct size. And typically, as a rule, you want to have the same text height as the icon height. So for example, here, you can see that my text height is roughly 24. And so my icon height is also 24. And at this point, we just need to set the proper gap and paddings. So let's start with a gap. We have apply variable and we have the button for gap, so 8. And then we have the vertical padding for the button, and it's going to be vertical padding. And then we have the horizontal padding, so horizontal padding. The same for corner radius. I'm going to set to a button corner radius, and voila, I have my button. At this point, you can customize however you want. Now, the cool thing about variables is that it's adaptive, which means that now that everything is using variables, I can just go to layer and switch colors to dark mode, and boom, it's adapting to the dark mode colors automatically for you. And so that's kind of like the magic of variables. And also you have the spacing, so the gap and the vertical padding and the horizontal padding. At this point, you can set the layer also using a spacing rule. So for example, you want to have a medium spacing rule. It's going to grow organically using the variable rules that we have set in place for you. So you don't have to do anything at all. And this is your button. At this point, you can customize. Let's say you don't want the background to be adaptive. That's fine. You can use one of the gradients that we have or one of the primitive colors that we have. So you have so many choices to choose from. So for example, you can use one of these gradients, gradients red, gradients blue. The choice is really yours if you want to adapt to light mode and dark mode or not. But if you do, then you want to use the variable colors. Otherwise, you want to set just everything to dark mode. So for example, if I want my background to have a very specific color, such as blue, but this blue requires that my colors and icon always is white. So I'm going to set, instead of setting manually the color of the text, I'm going to go to the layer itself and I'm going to set the color to dark. And so, you know, you give yourself a lot of flexibility for the future if you change the system and so on. So that's kind of like the basics of it. Of course, we can go into more details. So now we can create the component itself. So I'm going to go here, create my component, and I can set component properties. I'm not going to go into the super great details of it. So I'm just going to go with the basics, such as, okay, your button might have a text content. I'm going to set this as a component properties for text. And for the icon, I'm going to set this as a component property for the icon, the name being icon. But in this case, I'm setting true or false. So if you want to show or not, so I'm going to set show icon. And then also, I'm going to set the icon itself to icon. And you don't want to have a preferred value. You want people to be able to easily, you know, change the icon from the list that we already have organized for you. So if you set a preferred one, then it's always going to show the same one, but otherwise just remove it and it's going to show the list of the nearest icons. So I'm going to create these properties as a basic. Now that I have my button, I'm going to rename it my button. And then I can set my show the instance by going to Shift I and then search my button, and voila, it's right here in my design system. This is my instance. This is my main. You can see that these are the properties, and this is the instance when I use it in my design. And at this point, I can change the values that I have. Since I'm using auto layout, it's automatically adjusting everything. And this, likewise, I can change the text. Voila. And I can also customize the icon super easily. So that's kind of like the basics of creating a button using the design system. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any question, just send us a text and, you know, tweet. And I'd be happy to answer all your questions. Thank you so much.